one of them was here where the station of Maxim Gorky is situated, and this is the settlement called after Maxim Gorky. Of course, I think you don't know the name, the surname Gorky. He was a well-known writer in the Soviet Union, and at the end of the 19th century, he lived here, where the railway station was situated, and many goods trains were formed here, and now they are formed here in on the railway station. And Gorky lived and worked here. And then in 1952, the station and the settlement were renamed, and they were called after Maxim Gorky. And during the war, during the Battle of Stalingrad, there was one of concentration camps nearby. And now you can see that there are not only small houses, but also many storied buildings here. And on your left, there are trains, lots of them, because as I told you already, Volgograd is the crossroads of five railway directions. And many trains are formed here in this station.
Kate, what was the name before Gorky?
When Gorky lived here at the end of the 19th century, the name of the station was Krutaya. Then, after the Civil War, it was renamed in the 20s of the 20th century, and it was called Voroponovo. And then in 1952 it was renamed again, and it was called Gorky, after Gorky.
I know. Now that's important, because I have the divisions, the German divisions around
They began to build railways here in the middle, in the second half of the 19th century. And due to the railways, our city Tsaritsyn became an industrial center on the lower Volga. But the construction of the railways was very difficult. In 1861, they sent here about 2,000 workers to build a railway from the Volga to the Don River. Now we are going from the Volga to the Don, and they decided to have this railway from the Volga to the Don, from Tsaritsyn to the Don River. And those 2,000 poor people, they found themselves in the steppe land. They lived in dugouts. There were diseases. The conditions were awful. You can't even imagine how bad they were. And at last, it ended. On your left there is. There is a locomotive on your left, and this is to remind us of the trains of the past in our region, and not only in our region. I'd like to tell you about the fate of those poor workers who were sent here to build a railway. 500 of them died, 300 ran away, and the rest were not able to work. And yes, because they did not have food enough to eat, and the conditions were awful here. There were some diseases because of which many of them had died. And some journalists found out about the awful conditions in which the workers lived, and they wrote about it in the newspapers in Moscow, in St. Petersburg. A commission was sent to find out about the awful conditions of the workers' life. And 1 year after, again, even more workers, 2,500, were sent to the steppe land to build a railway. And the railway...
The Volga-Don Canal.
The Volga-Don Railway. The Volga-Don Railway. And they did it. But we always say the railway was built on the bones of the workers. They were not workers, I'd say. They were peasants. They were taken from Voronezh region. You will go to Voronezh. They were taken from Voronezh region, from some other regions of Central Russia, and they were sent here to build a railway. But it was built.
But the canal is there too.
Oh!
The Volga canal.
The Volga canal.